Good morning, all of you. Now we are starting chapter France Becomes a Constitutional Monarch. When we are talking about constitutional monarch, yesterday I told you the meaning of absolute monarch. Can anyone tell me? Only raise your hands. Can anyone tell me the meaning of absolute monarch? Yes, Devansh.
Ma'am, full power of monarch. Ma'am, yes. In which monarch do not have to consult with anyone to do anything.
Yes, very good. When we are talking about absolute monarch, that means king is having all the powers and he is not required to consult with others. Okay. Now next, we are talking about a constitutional monarch. Can anyone tell me this thing also? Now France becomes a constitutional monarch. What do you mean by constitutional monarch? Anyone? Yes, Bhavya.
Ma'am, when king make rules according to the constitution.
Yes. Now, according to the exact meaning, when king will act according to the constitution. When we are talking about constitution means rules and regulations. Yesterday also, I told you about what is a constitution. Constitution means rules and guidelines according to which a government runs. So same manner, when we are talking about France becomes a constitutional monarchy. Monarchy means king's rule. So now when Louis XVI ascended the throne at that time, he was the absolute monarch. Now in 1789 revolt, Louis XVI became the constitutional monarch because National Assembly has prepared. We have discussed yesterday that National Assembly prepared a constitution. Now Louis XVI will act according to. So now what happened after this? So when France becomes a constitutional monarchy, in 1791, National Assembly completed the draft of the constitution. And the main object, the main purpose was to limit the powers. And if you remember about that is role of philosophers, and one philosopher discussed about distribution of powers among legislature, executive, and judiciary. Isn't it? So here also, powers, instead of being concentrated in the hands of one person, like previously in the hands of monarch, now separated and assigned to different institutions. And that institutions still now they are part of democratic system. That is legislature. Can anyone tell me what do you mean by legislature? Legislature means, raise your hands only. What do you mean by legislature? Okay, legislature means who makes laws as National Assembly. Yesterday also I told you the meaning of National Assembly means parliament. Who make laws? And when we are talking about executive means that who implements the laws. And judiciary, that protects the laws. So here also you can just see a flow chart which prescribes the system of constitutional monarch in France. So instead of power in one hand, one person, it is separated and assigned to different institutions, legislature, executive, and judiciary. And now France, a constitutional monarch. You just see, legislature means National Assembly, which was having 745 members, which was elected by electors, that is 50,000 men. We are talking about 18th century where women were not considered. They did not get right to vote. Next is executive, that means king, monarch, and this is judiciary. Now you just see here, according to this constitution, citizens were divided among two categories, active citizens and passive citizens. when we are talking about active citizens, that means citizens who got right to vote considered active citizens. Is it clear? When we are talking about active citizens, now you have to tell what who were called active citizens. So when we are talking about active citizens, that is, you just see all men above 25 years of age and who were paying the taxes. Abhi niche aaye gaye aapka. You can see this system. You just see it here. Yes, Bhavya, can you read this topic? The Constitution of 1791. Okay, the Constitution of 1791 vested the power to make laws in the National Assembly. That means who got right to make laws? National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. And who will cast the vote? A group of electors who in turn choose the assembly, but not all citizens had the right to vote. Only men above 25 years, all men above 25 years of age who paid taxes. And how much taxes? That is equal to at least 3 days of a laborer's wage. They were considered as active citizens. They got only right to vote. And what about passive citizens? Passive citizens, when we are talking about passive citizens, that means remaining men, all women considered as passive citizens. And when we are talking about who will be the electorate, and then as a member, first, if they have to become the member of the assembly, so that means only a man, and who will be the highest taxpayer. So that means only rich section and man got the right to vote. Yes, Aryan, you want to ask anything? Yes, Aryan.
Ma'am, the power to make laws was in hands of National Assembly. So, ma'am, what did the king do?
King is having veto right. That's why we are saying that France becomes a constitutional monarch. He will implement the laws. When we are talking about executive, in today's reference also, you can see this thing. When we are talking about legislature, legislature means parliament. Parliament make laws, but who implements the laws? That is government. That is called executive. The same manner, king was considered as only executive because lawmaking powers were in the hands of king. Sorry, National Assembly. Got it? This is the same practice still going on. So when we are talking about right to vote, only men above 25 years of age and who were paying taxes. Or taxes kitna hai? Equal to at least 3 days of laborer's wage. Is it clear? Shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
In this book, yes, we yes, have ma'am. Just discussed about France becomes a constitutional monarch. That means what is the meaning of constitutional monarch? And after that, two types of citizens, this division of powers between legislature, executive, and judiciary. And after that, who got right to vote? Yes, Devansh, can you tell me who got right to vote?
And all the men above 25 of age and who paid taxes at least 3 days of labor's wage.
Very good. So, right to vote, and if they want to become the members of National Assembly, so what is the qualification they require? Anyone?
Highest, they have to be highest bracket of tax.
Yes.
Taxpayer.
तो फर्स्ट ही विल बी द मेंबर ऑफ इलेक्टोर सबसे पहले ही विल बी हैविंग द राइट टू वोट एंड आफ्टर दैट ही विल बी द हाईएस्ट टैक्स पेयर सो ये हमारा पेज नंबर 10 कंप्लीटेड एंड आफ्टर दैट दिस इज द पोर्शन लेफ्ट ओवर नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 1791 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 1791 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन द दिस इज सोर्स सी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक यू जस्ट सी The Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen. So now, men, when our constitution, जब हम अपने constitution को पढ़ते हैं उसका preamble देखते हैं तो it start, किससे start होता है We the people of India. Have you ever heard the preamble? सुना है ना आपने कभी पढ़ा भी होगा
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Books.
But here, this constitution start with Rights of man and citizens, and after that, rights. कौन कौन से who, what type of rights they got it? Still they are in practice. Right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before law, were established as natural and inalienable rights. That means they belong to each human being by birth. And could not be taken away. That means all got all these rights, and it was the duty of state. That means it was the duty of government. A government ki duty kya hai? That is to protect each citizen's natural right.